seems to be going decently. Hello, welcome back to Joyless Gaming, and in all honesty, I don't quite feel like streaming, but I'm about to move in a couple of days. Well, I mean, less than a couple of days. Monday morning. It's Saturday night. I'm going to move on Monday morning. I don't know when I'll be getting internet at my new place. That's got to be the most recent save, surely. 9:17, 10, yeah. Oh, pardon me. Anyway, yes, wait a minute. Is it that or is it a quick save? Damn. Anyway, so I've got to get back into this. And if I can get it finished tonight, I don't know if I'm actually close enough to the end to get it finished. But, see if I can get it finished, but I don't know if I can. Oh. Don't need that anymore. Trying not to waste ammo. Was there actually a reason to come here? Rather looks like there wasn't, really. Have I modified that one? No? Still don't know what I'm doing. implants. Okay. No, that's endurance. Actually, that's boosted my endurance. Why not? Okay, so. Came from here. I did investigate this way, didn't I? I hacked the turrets? Oh, damn it, there's a surgical thing there. It's actually been a couple of weeks since I played, so I have forgotten things. Forgotten lots of things. I didn't play last weekend because I was just absolutely buggered.
Simpson, Malone, Shandera, and- dislodge the meson acceleration coil. They blew out the entire driver core, 6 subdecks. From what I can tell, somebody tapped the frequency resonator to refract human-sized movements. The overload of all those people moving around must have blown the resonator. We set up a magnetic shield, and the ship's still functional. Barely. I've quarantined the entrance to Pod 2. The secondary coil is right there, and I don't know how thorough the son of bitch who did this was.
Okay. Do I have a thing? I do. Ah, oh, damn it. Damn it! Could have spared myself the use of a thingy. Up, what was the quick save option? I'm just going to be using that a lot, I think, because I can't find if I can't find the quantum reconstruction things, I don't want to lose lots of progress. Okay, quick save is Alt S. Goes no further than that? That goes going no further than that. Did I really look at this last week? I did not. I know it's a robot. Be above me.
Until I can reverse the gravitronic generators, we're effectively cut off from Pod 2. Wozcheck's email said the only way to do that is by resetting the power grid from the access station in engine nacelle B. Of course, he didn't volunteer to do it himself. What a goddamn mess.
Oh, so I have to go to nacelle B first. Which was this way, wasn't it? Oops. That's a cyborg assassin. Five left, huh?
Perhaps we judged you too hastily.
We feel there is room for us to coexist.
After all, we are both children of flesh.
Why not join with us?
Against the machine, Mother.
Ah. I mean, nanites have I got 500 and something, okay. Ah, oh, damn it. Fuck, yeah. Fusion cannon, eh? I already got a worm blood. Prisms, I guess prisms must power a fusion cannon then. But I don't have heavy weapons. So. Prisms, medical kit. Do those? Yeah, they don't seem to leave any fragments of stuff. There's three left.
Access needed.
Oh, damn it. Yeah, so I have to go back down there somewhere. Damn it! I thought I'd land on a thing. Thought I'd get off the fucking ladder and onto a thing. I did not.
Please make your selection.
Damn it. Damn it. Damn it.
Hey there. Please make your selection.
Reinitialized.
I don't know if trying to make less sound is a thing that there's any point to doing. I know this is the same engine they used to make Thief, but it doesn't mean that they put in the same mechanics. A Psy-Hypo. I don't need Psy-Hypos. I don't use Psy-Powers.
I am at your service.
Okay. Am I supposed to know what these correlate to? Ah, that's why the access has been lost. Ah, I see. All right. Am I not supposed to just sort of try and jump off the things? Rather seems like that's what you want me to do. No, wrong button then. Nah. Alright, it's not what they want me to do. I mean, if it is, I'm not doing it very well. Okay, it is. It's like you have to arc your jumps perfectly. Pretty sure it's something to do with jumping on these things. They just went and made it not very good. Oh shit, it's a ladder. I can't even fucking see. Right, so I'm okay. This is what I'm supposed to do, is I'm supposed to get onto there. Which means that one has to be up the top. Puzzle, but it's still, like, terrible. Terrible first-person platforming. And that's just meant to be nanites that are out of my reach. I don't know how much longer this game is. I mean, after I've destroyed these eggs, I guess.
Security system offline.
Can't see shit. Damn it. Somehow I've managed to get myself needing to pee again, even though I went before the stream. Be back in a minute. Alright. There's only like two of those eggs left. And I don't know if there's some sort of.
Security system online.
Direct confrontation with the many. Certainly hope there was a reason for that. Oh, it was the radiation hazard.
Security system online.
Oh, the torpedo was the radiation hazard. That's a rumbler. Shit. That is why there is a there was a security thing.
Security system offline.
Minute and a half. And get there and hack the turrets. Stop fighting each other. Strength and endurance are maxed out to try and keep me surviving. Skills, I mean, at this point, why do I bother? fucking hacking bullshit. Okay, so I'm supposed to do the Nacelle B stuff first. How do I get in there? I don't have the access card. And I wanted to go and do that, but I needed a bloody access card, and then you wouldn't let me in there. Now you're saying, no, I was supposed to go in there. Well, where's the fucking access? Told to go back and do something else that I had already tried to do. She looks watching me. Yeah. She's annoying like that. She says she doesn't like it, but she clearly gets off on it. How's it going, Melisomnia? Anyway, did I... No, this is from there, so back this way. Where... Where'd you come from? Another fucking respawning bloody... I guess it here. I'm rather tired and don't actually feel like doing this, but I thought I should try and get it done. Because... What was that noise? I thought I should try and get it done because I... didn't stream it last weekend because I was just buggered. And I don't know when I'm going to be able to stream again because I'm about to move. Cyber assassin. Shit! I didn't want to go down the whole thing. When am I moving? Monday morning. And it's Saturday night now, so... a bit over a day.
Hi there. Please make your selection.
Where is the... Yeah, I need a key card to get through here. Where do I get this bloody key card? But yes, I don't know when I'm gonna have the internet hooked up in my new place. So... thought I should get something done, and as I said, I didn't do this last week. For reasons. Ow! I thought I destroyed those things. There's... wait a minute, does that mean I have to go and talk to... hell, I'm shooting a giant spider with a shotgun. They're gonna be dead by now. Toxin, there it is. On the NBN, yes, I should be. Should have already been installed there. It's possible I might end up with a faster connection at my new place too. I can't, no, I can't switch that. I can't. Do I need to go and speak to Captain What's-His-Face first? If so, how? Shit. Well, I'm technically on the NBN here. It's just that I'm in a house that's been here for a while, so it's got the old connections, but the place I'm moving to was only built within the last couple of years, so it should be directly hooked up. And, oh, pardon me. Ah, shit. And my mother lives in that area, and she's occasionally had problems, but, yeah. There it is! Found the card. I found the thing I was supposed to get. Damn. First person platforming. Always a brilliant idea. I should have checked on that sooner. A lot of my complaining could have been solved if I'd walked down beside that console before. Ooh. So, this way, right? Yes, this way. Well, 3D platformers aren't so bad if platforming is the central mechanic and it's built with that in mind. If it's first-person platforming in a game that's not a platforming game, that can be annoying.
The vacuum of technology.
Yeah. What am I getting shot by? Motherfucker. I've got no ammo. But yeah, like, as far as 3D platformers are concerned, I mean, I liked the 3D Prince of Persia games. But they were supposed to be platformers. Whereas, you know, platforming in this game, which is not a platforming game, and it's in first person, where am I supposed to go? Ah, this way. It's so fucking dark! Shit! That sucks. Let me hack you. It's not letting me hack it. I'm not close enough to hack it. Ow! Okay, right. The fuck now? What? Who, what? Where? Sake! Shoot the egg! Jeez. Way to make it weird, Showdown. Get off the fucking thing! Oh, damn it. This is a different bed.
This device will reverse the gravitronic generators in pod 2. This will prevent you from clumsily disturbing the overloaded meson acceleration coil there. Now get back to your task, insect. The ship must be cleared, and my patience is dwindling.
And this is where we started. Right. Did she have like another message after that that I didn't hear because of? Nope.
Gravitronic generators in pod 2. This will prevent you from constantly disturbing the overloaded acceleration coil there. Now get back to your task, insect. The ship must be cleared, and my patience is dwindling.
Oh dear. Mine is a bit too, Showdown. Right, so this time I'm going this way. I've got no ammo. Absolutely none. You'll have to get health back though. We're supposed to go and meet Captain Diego at some point. But I probably haven't had a chance to get to where he is yet. Unless, of course, meeting him was not essential to progressing. This is when she says, get to the bridge. This is the bridge, obviously. This must be the bridge. Any meeting was optional. Oh, okay. Well, I mean, I don't mind. I'm out of ammo. I kind of want to see the end of this. Because I forget how it goes. I remember the beginning of the game a lot better. Because I... Oh, bloody hell. Tried several times over the years to get myself to play it again. And so I played the start quite a bit, but never got any further. Oh, near the shuttles. Oh, okay. Well, I'm kind of lost because this doesn't even have a map properly, so... I can only assume I'm on deck A, still. The support control, missile control... I must have been in there, missile control, because that's... yeah. SLA and B. umbilical, right? So there's going to be deck B and deck C, and I have no idea if you actually go back to the Von Braun? It's the right way. I think it was. Get up that ladder. There. There we go. Awfully convoluted. Actually, it has a minimap option, but yeah, there is no minimap for this bit. So I basically don't remember any of this part of the game. I remember that you had to get here, but I can't remember actually if there's some sort of mini boss fight or not. And after that, I know that you have to go back and... Wait a minute. You have to go back and deal with Showdown at some point. Yes, I've killed most of the turrets, or I've hacked a couple of them when I could, because I kind of wanted to have them watch my back, but... This, I think this, as it is, could have been just slightly improved if enemies didn't respawn. Then it could have been like a science fiction Resident Evil, where, you know, once you've dealt with the enemies, they don't come back. And then you're free to go back and explore parts of the ship. I don't want sight. Agility, okay, speed, falling damage, weapon kick. Oh, I mean, I don't have any other reasons to... Whatever. Look at that movement speed. Right, so we're on deck B. Accelerator, chapel, pipe access shaft, medical station. Great. That really sounds like a person making noises. Well, I don't have any ammo. Ow. Assuming what she means by a real alliance is that she wants to put herself in my body. Yeah, that's normal. I take a piece of crystal and I bash a robot to death with it. Hey, cybernetic assassins. Hooray! I love these guys. I have no bullets. I can't deal with these guys. I've got some worms, but they don't really work against robots. You don't want to tell me what's ahead. Well, I mean, fair enough, but... all I have is a fucking piece of crystal. Ah, for fuck's sake, I can't hit anything. Oh, just kill me already. Somebody left an assault rifle there. And by somebody, I mean the dead body there. That was a fusion cannon one? Fuck. It had two bullets in it. That assault rifle had two bullets in it. Those are anti-personnel bullets. I need armor-piercing ones. Well...
The genie of Citadel Station is out of the bottle, and I am the cause. I can't bear to be Pandora, and I'm not brave enough to wait around and see the death and misery I have caused. This is my last transmission, my friend. Be careful. I think Showdan has plans for you.
There were some cyber modules there, but, what was on the body? Nothing. So, fuck these guys. They can just sit there and pray to God. Shit! Okay. Right. I don't think there's actually anything down here. I was supposed to find the ladder and then... Nope, ladder, fucking hell. Why can you not grab a ladder that's right next to you when you've fallen off of it? Oh shit. Oh, I'm out of ammo again. Fucking... turrets. I remember that. I need stuff to research that. Oh, fuck off. Oh, there's armor-piercing bullets. Bloody hell. Shit! Why do I bother? Just wanted to see if there was anything else down here. Just death. Ew. That looks rather unpleasant. It's a fucking spiders, isn't it? Come on! They're not that fucking hard to hit. If they're that big, they can't be that hard to hit. Are they supposed to be translucent, or is that just a texture glitch? Can they not walk off of edges? Oh, bloody hell. Bloody hell! Ah! Fucking ladder. Now, the ladder is my enemy. Oh, that's a medical thingamajigger. That'll be good. Yay, health. The fuck is that? Okay. Diego's quarters, access card, okay. Oh. Is that Diego? Oh. That's a shame.
Those worms were a cancer in my body, so I had the auto doc cut it out. You think they're gonna let you blow up the Von Braun? The many will never allow it. But I've got something to help you. It's in my quarters. You'll find the access card on my body. Keep the fight to them, soldier. And remember, you're the only one to trust.
Okay. Oh, that'd be nice. It seems like toxins just don't go away.
Your skill surprises me. Transmitting cybernetic modules.
That? Wait a minute. That was it? Then it's just the top bit? Okay. Yeah. Command computer core escape pod. Sounds good.
Hold where you are, irritant. The analysts have tried my patience
for the final time.
We cannot separate from the Von Braun. Observe. The many has grown to a massive size. It has wrapped itself around these two ships, preventing their separation. Their creation was my error. Their destruction shall be my delight. Observe the many. It has used the flesh of the biomass to grow. Do you
you stand in awe of my creations, insect?
No, I'm just waiting for you to finish talking.
Time has come
to eradicate my error. There is an escape pod. An escape pod in the rear of the bridge. Use it to launch yourself into the depths of the world.
Okay. I have nothing to cure that with. Oh, okay, that sounds like that'd be useful right now. There's nothing in here. Map is no help because shit. Not happy with this situation. Why can you not hit things? Why is that so hard? For fuck's sake. What is this? Research skill higher than... Oh, fucking hell. Why do I bother? So where's this escape pod I've heard so much about? Oh. Is this the escape pod? Oh, it is indeed. Well, this is no good because I need some healing. I absolutely need some healing. Oh, there's nothing here. Well, isn't that just wonderful? This is infuriating. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die of damage over time. Repair the thing now.
Hi there. Please make your selection.
I mean, these aren't the best of options.
Hi there. Please make your selection.
Still not the best of options. It really is not the best of options. Yep, of course it's a toxic hazard. I don't have a hazmat suit.
The many hold sway here. Even I cannot maintain contact. You are on your own, human. Fail me not.
Flying things dragged me and David here last night. I don't remember much about the trip.
It's blacked out, half
blocked out. I keep remembering the part from Pinocchio, you know, where the old man goes looking for the puppet inside the whale. Except
Wait, so am I not supposed to be able to go through that? Ah. This thing sucks. And I'm dead. I'm not happy with this situation. And this thing, that, the viral proliferator, whatever it is, no, that's not the worm cannon. The worm cannon was the thing I didn't pick up. That's the viral proliferator. That thing sucks. There we go, that works. Oh, it was grenades. Get in there! Get, oh, for fuck's sake! First person platforming is fucking... Alright. This is where I give up, because fuck this, I'm sick of shit like this. But, do we have... Looking up cheat codes. So is there nothing... Nothing at all for, like, invincibility? Just items? I mean, I could give myself a whole bunch of healing items and ammo, I suppose. Appear to be summon underscore OBJ. Nah, fucking hell. Oh, that works. Detox patch. All right. I just sort of, can I do like numbers of them? No, can't do numbers. Right, okay, well, let's just that solves that particular problem for the time being. What else can I give myself to make things easier? Medical kit, okay, it's as simple as that. Really don't want to have to be typing this out every single time. Nice if I could find something to just make me invincible. Ah. Oh, editing a game file. I don't want to do that. Wait a minute. Let's see if that works. It appears to work, maybe. Let's see if it did anything.
The many hold sway here. Even I cannot maintain contact.
Should I presume that that's not working? I think I shall presume that's not working. That one doesn't work. So it's mostly detox patches and medical kits is what I want. There's a thing down here. Yeah. Of course, there's no map data available. Yeah.
When the passageway is open, the cluster seems to contract. Conversely, I wonder if I was able to destroy both clusters, it would open the blockage permanently. I'm anxious to see the rest of this beast.
Oh, of course it's radiation hazard. Why would there not be some sort of hazard here?
The machine mother cannot help you inside the biomass.
Darkness is not welcome within the walls.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, if you get to a situation where you can't progress, then... you're basically just screwed. That's where I came in, isn't it? Because this is, yeah, I went through here. Yeah, 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 I know it's a radiation hazard. Don't think I don't know. Fucking spiders. No, fuck this. Oh, fuck's sake. Yeah, this is not at all fun, and nobody can give me a fucking invincibility cheat, so... it takes fucking ages to go through this thing. Okay. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I don't know. This is, people are saying that you can create a configuration file. Well, I mean, I'm gonna give that a go. So I'll be back in a second. See about doing this. Alright. I mean, I'm still here, it's just the game is down. Where is my stuff? Is it? Yes, there it is. And there it is. Okay, so what do they want? How do I go about doing this? I don't want those. This is how much I suck. And now I need help with it. It's like they say create a file. And what are you doing? Oh yeah, save as. You just make it as a text file and then make it save as. Oh, all this silly nonsense. Okay, let's see if this works. Oh dear. I need a drink. Alright, well, maybe it isn't. Oh no, it is! I am finally invincible. Chemical storage, okay. Anyway, now that I've finally got that to go my way, you said before about the, you know, like how punishing this with the items and everything, that's one of the things that would be helped by not having the enemies respawn. Because then you'd have limited resources, but you'd also have a limited number of enemies to deal with. Because they just keep coming back, you're running around trying to explore stuff. So I need to find another one of those things that I shot before in order to get this to open. Is that right? Oh, is that it? No, that's just a big red thing. So that's just a big loop. After all that, I need to pee again. Bloody hell. Be back in a minute. Okay, let me try to calm down a bit. Drag my invincible butt through this thing now.
Please make your selection.
thought, well, there might be more to that, but there isn't. So this is where I came from, right? But yeah, like the whole, yeah, the thing about the resources is that there's only so much you have, and even with things like nanites and being able to make extra stuff, you know, the things doesn't really cover it because you don't get an infinite amount of nanites either, so it's always something there to drain your resources. Alright, so that goes there and that goes down that way, so the two things down this way went to the same place. I think. No, there was only the one thing down here. Ah, wait, what? How did I go backwards? No, the machines, you can't always get what you want from the vending machines. Yeah, these two things just go to the same spot. Where does this go?
Radiation hazard.
Is this a different one? Yeah, this is different, I think. Ah, there we go.
You tear our very flesh.
With no thought of compassion. Do you think we will sit idly by?
While you corrupt the very womb of our existence.
All you needed was just to not have to worry about health and resources, and then you can actually get through the damn thing. No, that's just...
Radiation hazard.
Yeah, yeah. I know it's hazardous. I am so toxic and irradiated right now. So, where was it? This way? Yep, there it is.
You seek your associates, but you cannot find them.
You are so very alone. How does it feel
to be one
against it?
Pretty sure I've heard them say that before. Oh, he said something about crunching. Yeah. It's like a giant tooth. I'm gonna sit underwater and listen to these logs. It's quieter under here. Oh, damn it! It's all buoyancy and floating to the surface.
There's some kind of horrible grinding noise coming from the next area. It sounds like chewing. I think I know what's going to happen here. This is some kind of digestive tract of a very, very large animal. I go back and forth between being fascinated and terrified. The creature's a remarkable discovery. I wish I could only live long enough to learn more. 5 minutes ago, one of those large, burly creatures drove close towards the sound of the grinding. Apparently, the animal uses smaller creatures to help move food along its digestive tract.
Ugh.
I tried to help Claudette, but it wasn't even a contest. And I'm ashamed to admit, I judged that seeing what happened to her was a vital element of my studies here. I imagine I won't have the opportunity to record any observations when it comes my turn.
Well, that's a fucked up way to look at it, mate. Oh, there's a spider there, too. Oh, it's just... I really don't want to be thinking about teeth and grinding and stuff right now. I chipped my fucking dental cap earlier today, and it's... reminding me that I have to, well, as if the sensation of it in my mouth wasn't reminding me enough, that I have to pay to fix that. No, I thought this might go somewhere useful once I spotted it, but no, of course not. Gotta do that first? What? Damn it. Why didn't anybody tell me? Ooh, wait a minute, is that a ladder? It is.
you moving inside of us. The sensation is
repulsive.
Indeed, I do have God mode on. I was just basically getting stuck. No ammo, no resources. And I was hoping to get this finished tonight, so... getting blown around by stuff. Logs.
While I don't understand the annelid life cycle fully, it's clearly extremely diverse. The eggs produce either a male or a female spore. The male, the drones, are wasp-like creatures. The female are worm-like annelids that seek out a host to infect. Following infection, the host begins to transform into a human annelid hybrid. From that point, the life form can take numerous paths. I believe this path is determined by the many itself. The creatures have communicated their need to grow the biomass, so I imagine that biological material is their primary resource. Therefore, each path has costs and benefits. The proto-arachnid is extremely quick and potentially relatively cheap in biomass. The hulking fleshy ones are powerful, but are clearly a larger investment.
Okay.
Besides the parasitic behavior evidenced in the life cycle of... Besides the parasitic behavior evidenced in the life cycle of the human-annelid hybrids, it's becoming clear to me that Showdown has bred the many to use humans for other purposes. First of all, the many clearly has the capability to convert human flesh to energy. It can eat us, but it can also directly use us in the creation of its egg pods. Corpses are fed into some kind of tubular structure, and eggs are birthed through a nearby tube. I've been unable to determine whether the organism is directly converting the corpses into egg structures or not. But it's clear that there's some connection between the nutrient pool we provide and the eggs that are being produced.
Yuck. Okay, so... fucking hard to see. Just going in circles, right, okay.
Thank you.
Ah, bloody hell. All I have is my hatred. I have a lot of it, but... why am I bothering to pick up resources? I feel like I should be able to do something to those membranes up there. I mean, do I even have an objective right now? Find the nervous system. Okay, find the nervous system and destroy it. Okay. Clearly been near here before. I'd really like to get this done because I have to go back and kill Showdan afterwards.
With only a few short years of evolution, they've been able to conquer this starship, mankind's mightiest creation. Where were we after 40 years of evolution? What swamp were we swimming around in, single-celled and mindless? What if Showdan's creations are superior to us? What will they become in 1 million years, in 10 million years? What's clear is that Showdan shouldn't be allowed to play God. She's far too good at it.
Surely this is getting somewhere. Have I been down there? I think I have. One would think that surely. Yeah. Well, the thing of it is, of course, you don't find out any of the story without listening to the logs.
No. I being taken away now. It's my turn. I'm being dragged into some kind of chamber. The ceiling is aligned with a number of panels, bristling with what appear to be stalactites or teeth. The creature's put me down now. He's leaving. I might have been spared. What's going on? It's dark in here. I can hear the moans of someone. Claudette? Is that you? There's something soft. Slippery. I'm still in tight.
They eated him. Vents of whatever and wherever they're coming from. Fuck these things. Seems like they're being shot by the things in there. Hello? Away. Just need to go and kill this thing. How do I kill this thing?
You have brought
not your
is a stranger to everything we cherish.
I'm just, like, glad for the we die part. Thank you for doing that. Finally. Yes, right. Well,
if you are receiving this, I am already dead. When I realized Shodan had betrayed me, I integrated these comments into her primary data loop. Shodan has exploited the warping capability of the Von Braun's faster-than-light device for her own purposes. The device works by altering space around the ship to fairly arbitrary specifications. Shodan has altered it to her specifications. The effect is rather small now, but spreads with alarming speed. Soon it will reach Earth. You are in her world now, her memories, and her rules. Watch your back.
Oh, okay. Hey! Nostalgia. Well, sort of. Virtual assassin.
You travel within the glory of my memories, insect. I can feel your fear as you tread the endless expanse of my mind. Make yourself comfortable. Before long, I will decorate my home with your carcass.
Looks to be fairly linear so far. Yes, we're playing the metagame. No, nothing up there. Why do I care about resources? I'm invincible. Yeah, keep throwing your ninja stars at each other. Anyway. Thing is, I remember doing this, but I don't remember this. But I remember that you had to do it, that it was a thing that was in the game. So was it in there then? Was it? Great. I'm dead. Well, that probably wasn't supposed to happen.
Toxic hazard.
Thank you for running my errands, puppet.
Wait a minute, did I?
I know you have.
I quick saved after it, didn't I? Yeah. Hazard. Didn't need the autosave. So I need to figure out what it is I'm supposed to do. Obviously it's something in the middle bit there, but I need to... I need to land safely. See, I would have thought I was supposed to go in there or something, but apparently not. Going up this time. Don't need prisms, don't need psi hypers, don't really need anything else at all, but right, is that not where I'm supposed to be going? It rather appears like I'm supposed to do something there, but right, now I need to walk up a walkthrough. What am I supposed to do? Go up or down? Pretty sure it's down. Well, I mean... that's what happens when I go down. Damn it, that almost worked. I almost stopped. Fuck's sake. I was trying to make jumps that I thought would have worked, but I just keep fucking sliding off the edge of stuff, and even when I was being a bit more cautious. This is what I mean about this bullshit of first-person platforming. It's like, we're gonna make you do this, despite how fucking bad the game is at it. Oh, that'll be it, right?
You must understand the stakes here. If Shodan is left to continue, her reality will completely assimilate ours. Space will become cyberspace, and Shodan's whims will become reality.
Okay, that's definitely a hole.
You are no longer welcome here, nuisance. Why do you stay? When you sensed my displeasure, I have suffered your company long enough. It is time for our dance to end.
Yeah. God damn it. Fucking game. Damn it.
Are you there, insect?
I enjoy your pain.
Welcome to my world,
Ha ha ha.
Record log, Tommy Suarez, 13 July 14. We've just received a hail from a crew member on board the Von Braun. They've managed to regain control of the ship. We're going to turn around and head back. I'm a little concerned about Rebecca. She's been acting strangely since we've come on board. She's asleep now. Maybe when we get back to the Von Braun, we can...
Tommy, what's the matter, lover? Don't you like my new look?
Huh. I expected something to come after that, I suppose, because normally they stick the credits after things like that now. Well, I mean, I didn't have much of a reaction to that, because I was just sort of, like, glad to get to the end of it. But I remember that you had to do that, and I remember that there was the whole thing of she'd taken over the, the winner is me, huh? She'd taken over the body, mind, whatever, via cybernetic implants. That's basically what she was proposing to do with you there towards the end to get you to spare her. And I guess they were hoping to maybe make a third game. And that didn't happen. But anyway. That, yeah, a lot of the stuff towards the end there, I didn't... Is it the same people making System Shock 3, though? I mean, the people that used to be Irrational Games. Because that closed down as well after Bioshock Infinite. I know there's somebody doing a remake of the original as well at the moment. That's supposed to come out next year, I think. Oh, yeah, like the companies, the actual development companies would have closed down by now, but they could still be the same people, just not the same name. The first one might have been War Inspector, but you might be thinking of Deus Ex. That was definitely War Inspector. I don't know about the first one of these, but this one was Ken Levine, who then went on to do the, writing Bioshock. But I'm not sure about the original System Shock. I've not actually played that. But I might be interested in playing the remake when it finally comes out. But, yeah, I mean, there's... I do complain, but mostly it's mechanical stuff that I find bothersome. And a lot of the actual game was sort of busy work type stuff, but a lot of games are that. But yeah, first-person platforming and in the 90s, it's not good. And, like, the whole... It would have been a good science fiction survival horror game if it weren't for the fact that the enemies respawned and your resources don't. Oh, the people working on SS... Okay, well, it's good to know that there are some people that worked on the old games that are making the new ones. And bringing experience they've had since then, although... Sometimes I get really annoyed and think that maybe younger people should be put in charge of that because the... But then again, sometimes I think the bad decisions might just be coming from management rather than from actual developers. I don't know. I'm up and down on the whole thing. I mean, just look at the name of the channel, after all. But, yeah, that concludes this. I did have to cheat because I just had nothing left and not a lot of patience. But it has concluded. And I still think it's definitely something that should be well considered. Issues aside, some of the things that I've got a problem with, lots of games at the time were doing. So basically, it was a fad in the industry at the time. My crystal stick, yeah. So, I mean, like, first-person platforming, I mean, that was what was wrong with Half-Life. I mean, among other things, but... Although I dare say I'd make a lot of enemies saying that Half-Life 2 is overrated. Half-Life 2 I barely played, but Half-Life was definitely overrated. I didn't find it all that great at all. And I didn't even play it when it came out. But it definitely was brought down by first-person platforming in low gravity. Constant boss fights, which was in this as well. You had boss fights in this, and that's... First-person shooters shouldn't really do that. But, yeah... In terms of concepts, storytelling details, the whole thing of finding the audio logs and all that was neat. It was actually pretty much the only way you got to find out the story and the backstory of things, but it felt like a rewarding gameplay mechanic if you went exploring and picked up the stuff and listened to them, that they would let you know what was going on. Which is good, because this was on the... sort of on the cusp. It was on PC, so, and it was never on anything else other than PC, as far as I know. Well, the voice acting was a mixed bag. I think most of the voice actors were actually the development team. So, some of them were good at it, some of them were not so good at it. But, yeah, this is sort of on a, like a, in a bridging period when games can be more complicated and have more information in them, but still sort of having that legacy of games that gave you most of the information in the manual rather than in the game. This thing is a bit more player friendly. I don't mind reading as long as it's not the primary purpose of the game. Unless it's a text adventure, of course, in which case, obviously, it's going to be reading. Oh, dear. But anyway, I complained probably quite a bit, but I do that all the time. But this is still definitely an old favorite, a classic. Just technical gripes more than actual creative stuff. Creatively, I think it was something that wasn't emulated enough, I think. But, yeah. One of your all-time favorites? Yeah, it was one of mine. I just never got to play it all that much. I finished it once years ago, and then I tried several times over the ensuing years to play it again, and just didn't keep playing it. Which is why, as I was saying earlier, I remember the early part of the game quite well, because I've seen it many times. I've never played it co-op, no. I mean, sort of, I did play it co-op. I didn't actually play it in co-op, but I did play it with somebody else in the room helping me through the game. Somebody else who played it, a cousin of mine. But, yes. Anyway, I think I should call that a night. I've finished the game. I've accomplished what I set out to do, even though it required cheating towards the end. I just wouldn't have made it through otherwise. And that still manages to make me walk away with it a positive impression, because if it had been still trying to manage the resources and barely making it through and then constantly falling down that fucking hole, I would have been so mad. You won't tell anyone. I'm going to archive the stream. Everybody's going to see it. Oh, dear. Two-player co-op, but imagine a cutback on backtracking, yeah. Yeah, so if you have unlimited health, you fall down a hole, you can't get out, that sucks. But thanks for joining me on this trip, Melisomnia. This is it's been interesting having somebody who's really into System Shock along for this. I actually bought this on Steam years ago, and I have never got around to playing it until this last couple of months. It's a good show. Well, I hope it was. I try to put on a decent show. But otherwise, yes, I've gonna go now and start uploading this to YouTube and trying to get some sleep, maybe. And I don't know when the next time will be, because, yeah, I'm moving on Monday, and I don't know when the internet will be hooked up. So, it could be a while, it could be quick, I don't know. Yeah. Well, I mean, I kept on thinking I was near the end, because I forgot. I remembered that you had to go onto the Rickenbacker, I didn't remember what it entailed. And then I didn't do it last week, because I was just so damn tired. It was a big day last Saturday. Well, the Friday was kind of big and stressful too, but anyway. So, yeah. I guess I can still say I'll see everybody next time, whenever, for whatever, but it's bye for a little while, because I don't know when I'll be back up. 3 more ships to explore. Oh, damn. At least the last couple of decks of the Rickenbacker were really short. Oh dear. But yes, thanks for your company, Melisomnia. I'll see you around. You said mobile internet? Yeah. I'll have something. It'll work out. Anyway. Bye for now and for the foreseeable future.